We can also use the second derivative to determine if a critical point is a local max or min. This is called the second derivative test. Why does this make sense? Well, if the second derivative is negative, then you have a graph that looks something like this. Well, if it's concave down like this, and we also know that the first derivative is equal to zero, then we're going to have a local max. Similarly, if we have f double prime of x greater than zero, so we have something that's concave up that looks like this, and we also know that f prime of x is equal to zero, then we have to have a local min. But what about if f prime of c is zero and f double prime of c is zero? So we have a critical point. The derivative is defined there, so we can even talk about the second derivative. But both the first derivative and the second derivative give us zero. What can we say then? Well, the answer is we can't really say anything at all because we really don't know what's going on. In fact, I can give you an equation like y equals x to the fourth, where at x equals zero, it has a local min, but has both a first derivative and a second derivative at zero of zero. We could do the same thing though with y equals negative x to the fourth, and it's a local max, or even y equals x to the fifth, where it's nothing. So if the second derivative gives you a zero at the critical point, this is inconclusive, meaning you can't use the second derivative test. So the second derivative test is really nice if it gives you an answer because it can do it really quickly. But if it gives you zero, then you're going to have to go back to the first derivative test. So this is a nice way to remember the second derivative test. If you have a happy smiley face, meaning your second derivative is positive, then it looks like this. This is what concave up looks like, and you can see from the picture then that that's a local min. Same thing here, your second derivative is negative, you've got a frowny face. You can see from the picture that's a local max. So this is an example we did in a previous video. We used in the previous video the first derivative test to find the local maxes and mins. Let's try it with the second derivative test. So we've already taken the first derivative and factored it and found the critical points to be 0, 2, and negative 1. So now we need to take the second derivative, f double prime of x, which is taking the derivative of this first derivative, 36x squared minus 24x minus 24. Now, to do the second derivative test, we just plug each of these critical points into f double prime. So f double prime of 0 is going to be negative 24. So what does that mean? That means we have a negative second derivative, which means that x equals 0 is a local max. Now, if we plug 2 into our second derivative, we get 36 times 2 squared minus 24 times 2 minus 24, which is equal to 72. So this is positive. So a positive second derivative means we have a smiley face. That means we have a local min at x equals 2. And now we can try f double prime of negative 1, which is going to give us 36 times negative 1 squared minus 24 times negative 1 minus 24, which is going to give us 36, which is also positive. So again, we have a smiley face. So we have a local min at x equals negative 1. So this is how you use the second derivative test.